Hello friends, myself Amar. Now, in this video, I will discuss about the concept of model in JSF. Okay, as I told you earlier that JSF is an MVC framework. MVC means model view controller. Okay, here the Java bean acts as a model, and the Java bean which acts as a model is called as managed bean. Okay, this managed bean contains the data as well as the business logic. Okay, let me show you in my slide. See, a managed bean is a Java bean class which contains the data and the business logic. A managed bean is managed by the JSF framework and it acts as a model for the JSF application. Okay, now once you have created the Java bean, this means the managed bean actually, it must be configured. Okay, and that configuration can be done either in faces config.xml file, or the configuration can be done in the managed bean itself by using annotation. Okay, now how that configuration will be done, that I will show you when I will write a simple program. Okay, for the time being, you just know that the Java bean which acts as a model in JSF is called as the managed bean, and to use that managed bean, the configuration must be done in the faces config.xml file, or the configuration can be done in the Java file itself by using annotation. Okay, now there is one more bean which is called as the backing bean. It is also a managed bean, but it contains the values retrieved from the OF form. Okay, now whenever we use the managed bean, or whenever we configure the managed bean either in faces config.xml or in the Java bean by using annotation, we need to specify the scope. What will be the scope means what will be the extent where we can use the managed bean in our application. That portion we need to understand. Okay, these are the different scopes. First is a request scope. What is request scope? This means here the bean will be created. This means the managed bean will be created whenever the request for that bean will come, and once the request is processed and response is generated, that bean will be destroyed automatically. Okay, then we have view scope. Here the bean will be created whenever the request for that bean comes, and it is destroyed whenever that view is changed. Okay, then we have session scope. Here the bean will be created whenever the request for that bean comes, and it will be destroyed when the user session or browser session is completed. Okay, then we have application scope. Here the bean will be created whenever the request for that bean comes, and it will remain available for the entire duration of the web-based application. When the web-based application is closed, the bean will be destroyed. Okay, these are the different scopes of the managed bean. Okay, if you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.